on the anointing this morning. Pull on the anointing this morning, because there is a word from God. So pull on the anointing this morning, because there is a word from the word of God. So welcome one and all to ReCharge Ministries this morning. And it is indeed my pleasure to release my sister into your hands this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. She is a woman that's blazing trails. I have watched her evolve, my God, as the Lord takes and use her in spaces where she could even comprehend. But because she has allowed the Lord to jump into her and him having his way, my God, this morning, we know that God is able and God is about to blow her very mind. He's already doing it. So this morning, I know that there is a word from the throne room of grace. Everybody, please welcome to the podium this morning, none other than
Alderene. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Sorry, I was having some difficulties and I had to switch to my phone. The devil is a liar this morning. The devil is a liar this morning. Man, there are just so many things happening. So many changes, so many things happening this morning, but the devil is a liar. You know, if the Lord gives you the appointment, he's going to provide you with every single thing you need. And that is what I believe. Hallelujah. So before we go into anything this morning, just let us pray. Let us pray. Hallelujah. 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 Mighty God, we give you thanks. We give you honor. And we give you glory. Yahweh is your name. We praise you. We honor you and we glorify you, Yahweh. We thank you for sending your son, Yahshua, to die on the cross. Jesus, the Messiah, to die on the cross for our sins. Mighty God, we thank you. We thank you for every provision that you have made for us so we could come and be a part, mighty God, of the family of God, rooted and grounded. We thank you. We thank you for your word that is constantly teaching us how to move, how to speak, mighty God, how to live, mighty God, how to manage the trials and the tribulation that life throws at us. We thank you. Mighty God, this morning, I thank you for ReCharge Ministries. I thank you for every single recharger. I thank you for every individual in the hearing of my voice, Lord Jesus. I pray, mighty God, that as I come before you this morning, Yahweh, that it might not be me, Lord God, but it be you that flows through me, Lord Jesus. Father God, I am simply a vessel, and all I ask you this morning is to use me. Father God, this morning I ask to crucify self. I ask to come up against the spirit of fear. Mighty God, I ask to come up against any single spirit that is inside of me this morning. I ask to remove it in the name of Jesus. And Father God, take the forefront right now. Yahweh, take the forefront. Take over. As Pastor Carl said, jump inside of me, Jesus. I need it this morning. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You know, I love to say what a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. This morning, I'm coming to you with a topic, and it's a topic that I've heard all my life. You know, the battle is not yours. It is the Lord's. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord's. You know, and this morning, and I want you throughout to say amen, because sometimes my thing come like it drop. I don't know what happens whenever I get up here. My thing sometimes drops. So I just want to say amen from time to time so that I know that you are all still there. Hallelujah. Pastor Mark read Joshua this morning, but I want to zero in on just one verse from what he read, and I'm going to zero in on verse 8, and it says, yes, it's coming from a real Bible this morning, and it says, and the Lord said unto Joshua, fear not, for I have delivered them into thine hand. there shall not a man of them stand before thee. And that is the word that I want to come with this morning. I want to tell somebody who is listening this morning, fear not. Fear not. There will not be, when this battle is over, there will not be one person standing in front of you. I know right now this morning that a lot of people are going through different battles, but I'm telling you this morning, fear not. Chapter 10 opens with five kings of Canaan joining forces. I want to feel it this morning, because sometimes you have some people that can't work alone against you. You have some spirits that can't work alone against you. So they join forces. So the chapter starts with five kings of Canaan joining forces to attack Gibeon because they had made a peace treaty with the people of Israel. These five kings didn't know, but they were playing right into the hand of Joshua. But instead of having to pick them off one at a time, they came together. So sometimes some situations are working against you. Sometimes some people are working against you. Sometimes everything not look like it's working, but it's all coming together for your good. It is all coming together for your good. I don't know who is it that I'm talking to this morning, but a lot of things are happening around you, but it's all coming together for your good. For Israel, it was just another battle of conquest. So I'm saying the same thing to you this morning. The battle that you're going through, it is not yours. The battle is the Lord's. And if somebody is in the audience, the virtual audience this morning, and you are telling me that you are not going through nothing, something is wrong with your Christian life, and what do we have something going through? Once you are a child and a child of God, the enemy is going to be coming up against you. And when he's coming from the north, he's coming from the south, he's coming from the east, and he's coming from the west. He's going to come at you from every single angle. Yesterday I met somebody and we're talking. I love meeting people who can talk about God. And I was having the very same conversation. And I was saying, as young people, and if there are young people on here, I said, when we're young people struggling with the sexual immorality, I don't know. I tell you people, I like to talk my truth. So when we're young Christians, that's the thing we struggle with. Sometimes we are not marrying people just because a lot of Christians are not marrying because of the struggle, of that struggle that they have. And so they end up in a marriage of turmoil. But when, as you grow older, so you would think that, okay, that one of the struggles you have as a youth. But as you grow older, the struggles are still there. The battles are still there. But I'm coming to tell you this morning that the battle is not yours. It is the Lord's. And you will remember this because it's something we hear every single day. The battle is not yours. It is the Lord. You see, the battles are reality of in the life of the child of God. But I need to tell you this. We never have to face this battle alone. In Hebrews 13 verse 5 and Matthew 5, in the day of battle, we have the promise of help from one who is ever present in a time of need. Psalm 46 verse 1. So I have a responsibility this morning to remind you of that. To remind you that our lives are filled with battles. However, these battles are not physical battles. I want somebody to get me this morning. The battles that we fight I'm not spiritual battles. I'm not physical battles. The battles that we fight are spiritual battles, because the word of God says we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Ephesians 6 verse 12, therefore our weapons must be spiritual. Spiritual, for the weapon of our warfare, they're not carnal, but mighty through the pulling down of strongholds. 2 Corinthians 10 verse 4. Listen, the battles, I want somebody to get this morning, that the battles that we are fighting, they are not physical. The battles that we are fighting, they are not physical. The battles are spiritual, and that is why we don't fight these battles alone. The battle is not yours. The battle is not yours this morning. The battle is the Lord. Sister C. Charlie, the battle is not yours. Brother Carl, the battle is not yours. Sister Hope, the battle is not yours. Malaysia, the battle is not yours. Sister Teresa, the battle is not yours. Tanisha, the battle is not yours. David, the battle is not yours. Ralston, the battle is not yours. Sister Patrice, the battle is not yours. Sister Nora, the battle is not yours. Sister Darian, can I tell you this morning that the battle is not yours? Sister Lanelle, can I tell you that the battle is not yours? Sister Michelle, can I tell you that the battle is not yours? Kayla and Bree, can I tell you that the battle is not yours? Nisha and Mervin, the battle is not yours. Pastor Mark this morning, the battle is not yours. Pastor Carlene, the battle is not yours. Sister Pauline, the battle is not yours. Sabina, the battle is not yours. Kay, the battle is not yours. And iPhone, whomever that is, the battle is not yours. I want to say to myself this morning that the battle is not mine. The battle is not yours. The battle is not yours this morning. Just in case you weren't listening to me, I just want to remind you. I just wanted to stick this morning. The battle is not yours. The battle is not yours this morning. Why is the battle not yours? He gives his peace. Notice the word that God used to Joshua. He said, fear them not. So I'm saying the same thing to you this morning. In verse 8, that's what he said. The Lord said unto Joshua, fear them not. So if the Lord is saying to you this morning, don't fear them. I got you. I got you. Don't fear them. I got you. He gave you his peace. There are some struggles that you're going through in your workplaces. God is giving you peace. There are some struggles that you're going through in your marriage. God is giving you peace because the battle is not yours. There are some struggles that you're going through in your financial situation. And God is saying to you, be at peace, because the battle is not yours. The battle that you fight is a spiritual battle. The battle that you fight is not a physical battle. Don't watch the people that come up against you. Don't watch the people that fight against you. Because God, he said, fear them not. God challenges people for them not to fear the enemy. He's reminding Joshua in this verse that, Joshua, remember, I am in control. So I'm telling you this morning that God is in control. Come on, somebody. Do you believe this morning that God is in control? Some of you have been fighting a battle for a very long time. But I want to tell you this morning that God is in control. And sometimes we want to take control from God. Come on. Sometimes we want to take control from God and do it our way. And do it our way. Just do it. I will do that. Say that again. Nike, just do it. Some of us want to just do it. We don't want to wait upon God. But I'm telling you this morning, be at peace, because the Lord is saying to you, fear not. Another thing is that God gave his promise. And I want somebody to absorb that this morning. God gave his promise. A lot of us have been in prayer, praying about certain things. And we hear the Lord speaking to us. He gave us his promise. He gave us his promise. So he did not just encourage them. He promised them. He said, you're going to have total victory. I don't know about you, but when the Lord tell me that I'm going to have total victory, I believe it. You know, it was this week. I just saw the ring on my finger. It was this week. I was telling my husband a little story, but it was a real story. I remember when I was in South Carolina, me and my husband, nothing at all, and the Lord was telling me all of these things to do. The Lord was, I remember the Lord told me to buy the wedding dress. I buy the wedding dress. Don't meet your husband. I remember, sorry, I don't know what's happening. I'm scratching my throat. I'm sorry. I remember the Lord, my niece called me and she said, you know, where's the space? Because I used to make these fancy dinners every Sunday. And I wore a big spread because I say I'm preparing for the family. And my niece called me one day and said, where's the spot for the husband? And so I put a plate at the top of the table. So there were only two, one chair for me, one chair at the top. Those were the only two areas that had any space for anybody. I leave a space on my bed. I didn't roll over. Make sure I don't roll over on that spot. Come and say, in faith, I call it the husband. And I clean out the closet. They put nothing in that closet. Absolutely nothing. I had two bedrooms and one of the closet was clear. I had to find places for everything that was inside there. Because I said, in faith, I'm going to have a husband and won't need their own space. Not that I'm saying the husband going to live with me, just a faith walk. But then, I said, as I looked at the ring, I remember what the Lord said to me. I had a brand new ring that I bought. I don't remember where I bought the ring, but I had this ring. And the Lord said to me, take that ring and put it in the consecrated olive oil. And I put the ring in the olive oil. I never remembered that until this. I was talking to my husband about it. And I put the ring in the consecrated olive oil. I remember a couple months before I met my husband, the Lord said to me, take out the ring and put it on your finger. So I was on my show with the rings. Everybody thought I was engaged, right? Because a little cute ring, like the smaller people did. And I remember when I met my husband, he asked me the question. He didn't even remember because I was reminding him. He said to me, you know, why are you wearing the ring? You know, and I don't know if God wanted me to ward off it. I don't know what it is. Me just know that he's going to give me victory and I just believe it. And I said to him, you know, it for me, I at the time I thought that God just wanted me to ward off. Remember? But that was what I thought. I don't know. He never told me why. I just move when God said move. And I said, you know, just the word off people. And he said, take it off. I took it off. And the rest is history. So just like I said earlier, God will give you a promise. And it doesn't matter how long it takes. When God told me that I was going to get married, it took maybe another 3 to 4 years before I met my husband, but I never stopped believing. I didn't start acting right away. Maybe if I started acting right away, I'd have met the husband before. Because my friend had to call me one day and she said, didn't you say that God told you to buy your wedding dress? And I said, yes. She said, you buy it? I said, no. She said, go and buy the wedding dress. You're the one who told me. So sometimes God needs to send somebody. But when he gives you a promise, whatever the battle is, because as Christians, like I said earlier, we're going through stuff. Every single day, there's something coming up against us. east, west, north, south, there's always something coming up against us. But the battle is not yours. It is the Lord. So God is going to give you his promise. God is going to open up the heavens for you. God is going to work miracles in your favor. Because sometimes we don't identify the miracles that are taking place in our lives. Sometimes the people that we connect with along the way is a miracle. There are some people we're not supposed to meet, but because they are destiny helpers, come on. Come on. Because they are our destiny helpers, we meet those people along the way. In my book, I talk about destiny influencers. Those are the ones who stay. There was a point in my life when I said, I can't have new friends. And over the last couple of years, I said, I'm too old for new friends. And over the last couple of years, God has placed some people in my life. I'm on this platform because I love myself to meet new people. So God is going to work miracles. There are some people you're in way in yonder. And they're all the way in Timbuktu. And you're like, you know, the people I need to connect with are all the way over there. But God is going to build a connector, and that's a miracle. So sometimes we look for the signs and wonders. Come on, somebody. They don't come in that way. And that is why it's so important for us to stay on our knees. So he is going to give us peace. He is going to give us his promise. And he's going to send us miracles. Just like how he sent hail. He's going to give us miracles. Hallelujah. Now, there's a debate about the sun and the moon standing still that day. And it was yesterday as I was reading, I was listening on YouTube and trying to, you know, do some research on the scripture that I was going to study this morning. There's this gentleman, and he was saying it's not possible for that to happen. But I zeroed in on one comment. While I was there listening, I was actually driving, and while I was there listening, this one person said, God can do anything. If you believe this morning that God can do anything, say amen. Because, or hallelujah, whatever you want to say, because there's nothing. I love to say, there is no secret. What God can do, he did it already and he can do it again. The word said, after he stopped the sun and the moon and lengthened the day, it never happened. Nothing like that ever happened again. But as I continued to study a little more, it says that ancient history, come on, it says that ancient history supports this claim. It said the Chinese, come on, he's going to leave a witness. The Chinese, the Babylonians, the Incas, the Aztecs, the Egyptians, the Assyrians, and a lot of other culture said in that time, everything coincided that they observed that the day had lengthened. Come on, somebody. So here is a contemporary person saying not possible because science says it can, you know, make no sense. It is impossible. But we serve a God of the possible. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord's. You're sitting in the situation right now and you're saying nothing is going to happen. You're going to say the change will not come. You're saying right now, how can I make it over my own Jordan? How can I stand up against my Goliath. I'm in darkness. How can there be light? Extended light. It won't happen, but I'm saying to you this morning, the battle is not yours, it is the Lord's. So people can want to dispute as much as they want to about what God can do. And like I said, that is what I zeroed in on. I didn't even read this part of it yet. About the ancient Babylonians and everybody seeing it at that time. So historically, it has been recorded. Come on. So what do we need to do? One of the things we need to do is that we have to stay in control of our enemies. We have to stay in control of our enemies. Our spiritual eyes have to be open. We have to be alert. Because remember, when I read it, I was like, man, the five kings, they come together, and a lot of times that happens, people team up and come up against you. We're having a situation of people in workplaces, and it's not one, it's not two, it's not three. Everybody coming up against you. And imagine they teamed up with their army, and when they realized that they were losing, they went to hide. And a lot of people do that. They will let the enemy use them to say all kind of things about you, to do all kind of things to you. And when the attack clubs come, they will hide behind their lies. They will hide behind other people. They will play a game like Adam and Eve. It's not me, she's not, she's me. It's not me, it's she. It's not me, it's him. But you have to be in control. You have to be able to identify what is going on with your enemy. And I'm saying, how did they even know that the kings, somebody saw them? Somebody must have seen them. But if nobody sees them, let me tell you something. The Holy Spirit knows. And the Holy Spirit said, I will bring you into all truth. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord. The Lord is in control. He'll tell you what to do. He'll tell you where to go. He'll tell you how to do it. Stand still and watch God work in your life. So we must be in control of our enemies, must know their whereabouts. Joshua said, go get them. Josh, go back. You can go back and read. Joshua said, go and get them. When they hid. And they knew where they were. Nobody don't pay them any mind because it was not time yet. Then when it was time, Joshua said, go and get them. Go and get the five kings. He was in control. He was in control. And when he said he knew where they were, and then we must confront our enemies. And I remember earlier I said the battle is not a physical battle, it's a spiritual battle. You go down on your knees and you're fighting battle, fasting and prayer, sackcloth and ashes. Certain things not come, the word of God says certain things only come through prayer and fasting. So we can be praying, but that alone, we need sacrifice. So then we have to fast with prayer and fasting. Things will come to fruition. If you're single, don't stop praying. Don't give up. I was single for over 12 years. And that's why I was on my show the other day and I said, nobody knows the days that I lie down. Listen, when you pray on your belly, it's a different type of prayer. When the Lord said to me, lie down on your belly. Nobody saw that I was lying on my belly. Crying, literal tears. I said, God, I don't want to end up alone. I need a husband. So I said, wherever he is, send him come. And I started going on YouTube and I find all the husband prayer that them have. And I play them in the house. I play them. Everybody who have a husband prayer start researching them. Come on. It's a spiritual battle. And that's why the word, the battle is not yours, it is the Lord. It's a spiritual battle. But we still have responsibilities. We can't stop praying. We can't stop fasting. I lived a life of fasting Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. The only days I wasn't fasting was on Saturday and Sunday. Every day. Bawling to God, crying, praying through my prayers. Crying through my prayers. Just stay at the throne. It's not over. I don't know what you are going through. I don't claim to be no prophet, so I don't know what you are going through this morning. But what I can tell you is that the battle is not yours. What is yours is victory. The battle is not yours, but victory is yours. Victory belongs to you. There's a songwriter that says, victory belongs to you. And so we must control our enemies. We must confront our enemies. So that's why Joshua said, bring them come. Bring them come. Let me see them. This is spiritual warfare. I am going to face it head on. Morning manna, blessed be the Lord. Listen, I don't get the chance to go on morning manna like I used to, but man, Friday morning, I came in for work. I didn't even sleep. I said, no, I'm coming on morning manna this morning. I never realized. I make sure I'm about the third or the second person to pray. Because I said, no, I need to be on morning manna. I need to be on morning manna. We must confront our enemy. We must conquer our enemy. So when he called them, he said, bring them come. You have to annihilate everything out of your path. You have to annihilate everything out of your path. We must fight daily. We must fight daily. So in your mindset, you have to understand that you must control your enemy. You must confront your enemy. And you must conquer your enemy. Because God has already given you the peace and the promise. Victory is already yours. And like I said earlier, you have to fight on your knees. Not no physical fight, not cuss nobody, not throw no word on Facebook or Instagram or wherever you are. You don't have to do all that. Or any status on WhatsApp, don't throw any word on anybody. Fight your battles on your knees. Every single day there's going to be a battle. Fight those battles on your knees, because the battle is not yours, it is the Lord. What you have is not the battle. What you already have is the victory. Hallelujah. When you're fighting, you have to fight with determination. You have to be convinced that the battle is yours. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things that you cannot see. You have to already believe that it is done. You have to already believe that it is done. It is finished. Like Jesus said on the cross, it is finished. It is done. Jesus already said, he said, done, it's finished. So when you fight, you have to fight with determination and conviction. Come on. We must fight with devotion. Joshua was devoted to God. So I'm asking you this morning, are we devoted to God? And I like saying we. Are we devoted to God? Joshua was devoted to God. The other day, the Lord said to me, I don't even know, God just hear my spirit, they're going to ask you who you are. And your answer is going to be, I love the Lord with all my heart and all my might and all my soul. And I keep saying, I keep saying to God every time I go from him, he said, God, if you are not going, I will not go without you. If you're not coming with me, I'm not going. I don't know where, but I say, God, every day I get up on a prayer and I say, God, if you are not coming with me, I am not going. So when you're fighting as a devoted person to God. We have to be devoted to him. We can't have anything a sidetrack with. We can't have anything causing us to look back. Like how Lot's wife had to look back and turn a pillar of salt. We have to just keep focused and devoted to him. There are so many things around us that will cause us to lose our devotion to God. Just like I said earlier, even just as a young Christian, you have different struggles. When you get older, you still have the struggles. You still have struggles. They might not look the same, they might not feel the same, but the struggles are real. So you have to fight with devotion. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord's. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord's. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning. Paul says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Devotion. Your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Your labor is not in vain. Sometimes you have people who feel like, okay, I can't do this anymore. I can't do this anymore. Micah 6 verse 8, he had shown me, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but do justly, and to love mercy, and walk humbly with thy God. Devotion. In conclusion, Ecclesiastes 12 verse 13 says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God, keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. So if we stay devoted to God, let us backtrack, backwards, let us walk backwards. If we stay devoted to God, and fighting determination. Have determination. Fight daily on our knees. We will control our enemies. We will be able to confront our enemies. And we will ultimately be able to conquer our enemies. Let us always remember that as we go out there every single day, God give us his peace. He give us his promise. He gives us his peace. And he gives us his promise. We're already at peace. He said, the peace that passeth all understanding. I remember a couple of years ago, I was a mess. My back's splitting. And I remember when I curse, the material long from here to the over there. So and I remember going to New York to visit. I was in Jamaica. And I went to New York to visit. And I tell you about the youthful days. To visit a friend. And we were outside and we were drinking. And I said, man, I'm tired of being broke. I need some money. Money's what makes the world go round. I remember my friend looked at me. Another friend wore a statement, it was another friend, and she said to me, she said, no, the peace of God, and she's not a Christian. But before that, I remember her looking at me, and she said to me, she said, Alderene, if you're not like us, who's going to pray for us? Because when we're in college, I was always that person pulling them, okay, let us pray. You know, if after college, when we meet up, let us pray, and she asked me that question. And she said, that was, you know, she kept saying some very profound things, and that day, I remember coming from New Jersey from visiting my cousin, and she said, who's going to, she said, It's a peace. And I remember going to my room that night and I knelt on my knee and I said, God, I need your peace. I said, I need your peace. Because on my way, I flew that day when I went to New York, I flew from Florida. Because I came to Florida to visit my family and then flew from Florida to New York to see my friend for a couple of days. So we all meet up because we haven't seen each other in years. And when I was on the plane, the Lord was talking to me. And a lot of the things that I'm seeing now in my life, the Lord already told me years ago. And he told me in my mess. And it was the first and only time I flew in first class. And God, maybe I've had a reason for that. And I was in this big old seat and tears were just streaming down my face. And there was this man over on the other side. But you know, in first class, there's so much space. And the man wasn't looking over at me and I was just crying. I started by looking out the window and then the Lord just started speaking to me and tears were just streaming down my face. And today, what I can tell you is that I found the peace of God. So much things are happening around me, just like you. So many disappointments, so many struggles. But what I have above all things is the peace of God. He will give you his peace in battle. He will give you his peace. He made you a promise, and all his promises to you will come true. Trust God. Trust God. If there's anyone, you know, on this morning, who needs his peace, you can just raise your hand. If there's anyone this morning who's fighting a battle, you can raise your hand. And that should be all of us, because my hand is up like everybody else. But the battle is not yours. Just remember, God gives you his peace. He gives you his peace. He gives you his promise. And he will walk you through. You have some responsibilities, but in the midst of it all, always remember, you have his peace and you have his promise. And his words can never return to him void. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us pray. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. Mighty God, we come before you today, mighty God, not just for myself, but every single brethren and sister who is on this line this morning. As they fight their own battles, as they go through their own struggles, remind them, mighty God, that your peace has never left them. Remind them, mighty God, that you have already given them your promise. Mighty God, show us, mighty God, how to conquer our enemy. Show us, mighty God, how to confront our enemy. Show us, mighty God, how to be able to identify who they are. Remind us, mighty God, continually that our battle is not a physical battle. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities and rulers of darkness in high places. So this morning, teach us how to fight our spiritual battles on earth. Teach us how, mighty God, to continually have faith. Teach us, mighty God, how to continually seek your faith. And Lord, remind us that the battle is not ours, it is the Lord. Cover us under your blood. Cover me right now, mighty God, from the crown of the head to the sole of the feet. For any word, mighty God, that I have directed to your people, that the enemy want to come up against me in the spiritual realm right now, be my covering, mighty God. Cover me from every single attack of the enemy and set every single plan and plot of the enemy to the pit of hell where it belongs. Cover your children under the blood this morning. Let nothing harm them. Go into homes this morning, Lord Jesus. Send your deliverance, send your healing, send your peace. Father God, thank you. Thank you for Pastor Carlene and Pastor Mark and their children. Bless their family continuously, mighty God. and give them the strength, mighty God, to continue to grow this ministry just like you want it to grow. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the sweet Holy Spirit, we give you praise and we give you honor. Thank you, Lord. Pastor Carly.
Hallelujah. What an awesome God we serve this morning. What an awesome God. Evangelist Lisa, please stay on camera. I truly want to thank you for this awesome word this morning. And some of the key points that Evangelist Lisa just brought forward. I call her Lisa, but it's Alderene Foote, Evangelist Alderene Foote, is control your enemies, meaning our spiritual eyes must be open. Second is confront your enemies, not in the physical, but in the spiritual, and conquer your enemies, because the battle is not yours, but it's the Lord. But what impressed me was this last statement that you mentioned, Evangelist Lisa, was where you said, your friend said, if you are like us, who is going to pray for us? If you are like us, who is going to pray for us? Wow. That hit me in a different way. If you are like us, who is going to pray for us? So when we're out there straddling the fence, if we were, you know, a part of Christendom that we went back into the world, there are many of our friends that are thinking the same thing. If you are like us, who's going to pray for us? Because even though they didn't tell you with their mouth to pray for me, they were there saying, I know my friend, I know my sister, I know my brother is praying for me, because they're in the church. But when you come out of the church and you're like them, they might be saying the same thing that Evangelist's friend said. If you are now like us, who is going to pray for us? It's important for us to stay under the mighty hand of God. It's important. The battle is not yours, but it's the Lord's. Let the Lord fight your battles for you. Let the Lord fight your battles for you. Stay on your knees. Stay on your knees, because that's where the battle is won. This was an amazing message today. The battle is not yours. For all of us that are going through, the reminder is the battle is not yours, but it's the Lord's. And when you begin to shift your understanding, when you begin to shift your position, the battle is won. So remember this morning, the battle is not yours, but it's the Lord's. And I pray that you get that this morning, and it's resounding in your heart and in your mind, that the battle is not yours, but it's the Lord. Victory's won when you turn it over to Him. We here at ReCharge are here for you. We're here to pray for you and with you. And if this morning you are in need of prayer, please just drop us a line, whether in the chat room or you can personally message us this morning, because we're here to pray for you. Because the battle is not yours, but it's the Lord's. May the Lord bless and keep you this morning. This is ReCharge Ministries, and we're here to pray for you and intercede for you. May God bless and keep you.